Welcome back to the Motor Fab YouTube channel. How are we all? Enjoying this bit warmer weather? I know I am. For those of you who didn't see, I think everyone's sort of used to my post on over the weekend. So if you didn't, and I didn't label it the same and all that sort of bizzo. So if you didn't see, check out the channel. There was a bonus episode midweek, this week just gone. So you had episode 13 last week, a bonus episode, and now this episode 14. So there is a short one in between. It's only a half length episode. But jump on that. So if you didn't see it, it's just a quick recap. I put it up because some exciting stuff's happened. I've entered to race. Hopefully the Monaro. I know it's nowhere near done, but the July 25th, there's a race meet out at Warwick. No prep cash days set up. So I've entered this. Hopefully if it's ready to go, I'll race it. If it's not, I've got the old ute over there. It's ready to go. So I'll just put some fuel in it and change the spark plugs and away we go. I'll have to practice me trans brake cutting down the tree. It's been a while since I raced. Ready to ride last year. So that's pretty exciting news. And also, I entered Summer Nats. So Monaro will definitely be ready for Summer Nats. It's happening. Like I said in the episode through the week, I've never been to Summer Nats. So I'm really, really pumped. So yeah, can't wait to cruise around in the Monaro at Summer Nats. It's going to be a sight to see, that's for sure. And meet a lot of people from down south that I've yet to meet. So I'm excited about that. Your VPW discount, don't forget that. You got your 10% for another 3 weeks. So June 21st, that's all over and done with. So get in now and use the code word. Here it is, had a few messages asking what's the code word again. There it is right there, MotorFab. It's an easy one. So use that up, use it to your advantage, enjoy. Also in the episode, you will have seen that we got the new cylinder heads, or secondhand cylinder heads for the Monaro. So we've now got cylinder heads, cam, lifters, obviously block, crank rods, pistons, all that was already in the motor that I bought, the secondhand engine that I bought. So I've just got to get some rings, gaskets, an oil pump, and timing chain. And I'm pretty sure that's about it. And then the engine's ready to go back together. The gearbox is already going together. Just got to do the dreaded bloody pipes on it then, which, yeah, I'm not looking forward to. Everyone keeps telling me, oh, they're tight. Oh, I know they're tight. I'm sucker for punishment. But I'll get them. I'll make something work. Worst case scenario, just because of the time, I would prefer to put a rack in the car anyway, but time frame, it's easier to try to make the pipes work. But if I can't make them work with a tight, confinement, I'll put a rack in it. I've got a few racks upstairs, so be all good. I'll get it sorted. This episode, you got the brakes, the Wheelwood Master, and the MotorFab kit with the pedal assembly. It's a sneak peek of a new product that we've been doing for years, but we haven't marketed as a product. It's not on the website yet, so they will be ready on the website very soon and shipping out Australia wide. Also, because of the channel, we're getting a lot of inquiries from overseas. These cars didn't just come out in Australia, they did come out in other countries. So I'm getting a bit of interest in products for them overseas. I'm working on a freight setup. So my freight company that I use within Australia here don't go to some of these countries. So I'm sorting that out. So that's really exciting that we're starting to ship out around the world. Appreciate the reach that we're getting. I really appreciate the feedback. And so you got your discount, your races, the brakes. I think that's pretty much everything. This episode will go into detail about the brakes. There's some really, really into detail about some of the mathematics in why I use the setup that I do, because you guys seem to like that. It's all happened. I just got to hook in and get it done. It's been really busy here at MotorFab with orders, so I haven't been able to dedicate hardly any time to the Monaro, but hopefully I will. I'm starting to catch up. Everything's starting to arrive. We got batches of suspension kits. We got batches of in laser. We got batches getting welded up. We got batches of powder coat. They're coming out of ears, so it's starting to flow back on how it used to, so the orders will start to go out quicker and quicker. So all those guys that are watching the channel that are waiting for orders, they're on the way. And I'm working hard to get that wait time down. COVID's just been a little taxing in that department, but we're getting there. Getting back on top of things. So big shout out to everyone that is contacting me about our Chevy dog. He's wandering around here somewhere. He's up there on the driveway having a sleep, actually. He's looking at me. I think he likes the attention. So thanks, guys. Appreciate it. And get stuck in. I'll stop waffling on and enjoy the episode. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Let's do it. Like and subscribe. Rightio, let's talk about brakes. For those of you who tune in for the technical segments, you'll love this. There's lots of jargon. And for those of you who get a bit bored when I waffle on and get too in detail, well, this might have skipped this a little bit. It's going to be a little bit in depth. And just as a side note, I get asked a lot by, especially young fellas that, you know, want to get into the car scene, want to get into the modification scene, and what do we do? How do you get into it? All that sort of stuff. My advice is, especially if you're still at school, young blokes out there watching, stay at school and study physics and chemistry. I know it sounds boring and you don't want to do those subjects because they're a bit geeky, but you will use so much of it in modifying cars. I use geometry every day, physics every day. And then when you get into the tuning side of it, you know, chemistry is also a little bit there, but mostly geometry and physics really plays a big part. But simple maths is very important too. Very, very important. So enough about that. So yeah, just all you kids out there, study your maths and your science. And for your dads out there with kids that want to get into it, make them study their maths and science. So let's talk about brakes for the old Monaro there. This is our new front caliper that we're using. Gone through it before. It's a HZ caliper. I've had it all rebuilt. Nice big piston. You will notice they're a single-sided, single piston arrangement. So they run a slide setup. It can actually be a little bit prone to jam and failure. Not the greatest caliper out there, that's for sure. Our whole reason for upgrading these is I know they work. I know this recipe works well. But they have their few issues. So you've got to recondition them and look after them to get the most out of them. Not the best design, but when you compare it to... This is a factory caliper that came off the Monaro. The old Gerlach, big heavy things. But they're not a bad caliper. They're actually a twin piston. So there's no slide to jam or anything like that. Their biggest downfall is these tiny little pads. And accompanied with a non-ventilated rotor... Their heat was their biggest downfall. They really get hot really quickly. But hydraulically, they're not bad. So what we're going to go through here is a braking system and probably the bits that most of you guys aren't aware of. So we're going to this master cylinder, these calipers, and the Commodore calipers are on the back, and they're already on, so I can't show you that. So, and we'll pull the pedal out because I'm going to show you that's very important. So people always question me, okay, number one, booster. Don't need a booster. Show me a circuit car with a booster on it, and I'll show you a faster one that doesn't have one on it. You don't use them. Mainly for the fact you got your engine screaming at 7,500 revs down the straight at 200 plus kilometers an hour, and you jump off the loud pedal and jump on the brake, and all of a sudden you've got a large vacuum pump making a hell of a lot of vacuum, and you've just put your foot in the brake pedal and gone through the windscreen or locked the wheels up. It's very uncontrollable when your vacuum fluctuates like that when you're at high revs and shut the throttle. So boosters aren't necessary, but it is necessary if you don't want to run one, especially that big block. We can't really have room for one. But if you don't want to run one, you need to have all these numbers here we're going to go through. You need to have your ratios right to make it all work. So I'm not going to go into boosted and non-boosted ratios simply because of the fact that there's so many variables. I'm not even going to go right into hydraulic ratios with you because there's so many variables, pounds per square inch of the backside of the vacuum, the diaphragm on the booster, and the losses in expansion of the rubber lines. It's just... It really is complex, and it's a job for engineers to spend a long time on developing a car. So we're going to piggyback some of their info I do know how to go through it, but it's too much and it's too involved. We sort of more work towards, we get a recipe that we know works, trial and error, and we stick with it. But a bit of education in that department goes a long way. So I will run you through VT Commodores. This is just to give you a guide of what we're doing. Their brakes on them work very, very well. Master cylinder is a 1-inch master. Bio 3.14 to get an area is 79.5. Front calipers, they're a 40.5 mil diameter cylinder. There's four of them. Gives us 508.68. Don't worry too much about the numbers. It's just more the theory behind it. Rear caliper is the same, 44.5, but there's only two of. So that gives us 254, which gives us the 763.02. That's our whole area of all of our pistons in all of our calipers. And then our 79.75 is our area of our master cylinder. So then divide the two, we get a 9.56 hydraulic ratio. VT Commodore has a 6.9 pedal ratio, giving us a 65.96 overall ratio. That's pedal ratio included. Now, if we go to our new setup that we're doing, we use a 7/8 master. Now, this is what I've been getting a lot of questions about. Just do it, don't doubt me. I know it works, but let's put some theory to it. It's a 7/8 master, 22.2. Our area is 69.70. So our front calipers, this is this caliper here. This is our area. Our rear caliper is a Commodore. It's the same as the VT. This is our area here. That's our overall hydraulic ratio. Is our overall calipers. Master cylinder ratio, then our overall ratio. So 9.36 is not too far off 9.56, which is our VT Commodore versus our setup we're going to on the Monaro. And this is where it gets interesting. We are going to modify this pedal. We're actually going to put a new pedal in that we make at Motorfab. That's a product that's very new, but we've been doing them for years. We haven't sold them as a product yet. We just do them as per needed, but we are developing a kit again that's going to be sold in the market very soon. So once we modify our new modified pedal, is 6.4 pedal ratio, giving us a final overall ratio of 59.9. Not too far off our 65.96. Now, to give you some comparison, this old car here, we've all driven them. If you're interested in this channel, I'm sure you've driven a HK or T or G Holden. You know how terribly they stop. We'll just wait for the genius to go past on his motorbike with no mufflers. So these cars, the braking was terrible. So a couple of the issues, the little brake pads on the front, bad for heat. The non-ventilated rotor is really bad for heat. So you only got a couple of stops. But even those first couple of stops were terrible. Now I'm going to show you why. And it's not what you think. So our front calipers, they're a really good caliper. They're twin piston, no slides, nothing to jam. They're twin piston. We went back to singles and we were there for decades before we went twins again. So they weren't such a bad caliper, except for they only take a non-ventilator rotor. So the area of them is actually quite big. It supersedes all of our areas. It's the biggest one there because it's got these two huge 47.8 mil diameter pistons in there. So our front calipers hydraulically, heat, yes, hydraulically, no, not a problem. Our rear, now we've got drum brakes in the rear and they're very small cylinders. That's a big letdown. You see this number here is very small. But this number here is so much bigger. So our ratio front to rear is not good on them. But our overall is actually still, because of those front calipers, bigger than the rest. It's actually slightly bigger than a VT Commodore. But the VT stops and the HT doesn't. Master cylinder, they're a 15/16, so you got your 23.8. So this area here, it's not too bad. It's over our Willwood, but it's under our thing, so it's in the range. So we got our numbers coming along. 9.89 ratio, you can actually see, is better than our other two cars. So theoretically, the thing should be stopping better. This is where we fall apart. Pedal ratio, 4.1. Final ratio, 40.58. as opposed to 59.9 and 65.9. This thing here is the one part nobody changes when they upgrade every other part of the braking on their old cars. It's not just KTG model, it's a lot of old cars. The pedal ratio was terrible. It's trying to compensate. If you put a big pedal on that car with the rest of the components in place, the front wheels are just going to lock up every time. So the combinations, engineers hadn't put as much homework into it. I didn't invent this, I'm just piggybacking off what other people have done along the way, engineers and stuff like that. So yep, we got to get rid of them because of the heat, but we also have to address this. So that's why we're going to sell a new pedal to go in these cars to correct that pedal ratio. So if you look at our numbers that we did for our setup, we're taking our pedal ratio up to 6.4. So from 4.1 up to 6.4, which is getting up closer to a VT Commodore. A reason I referenced the VT is we know they stop pretty well. And I have all the numbers already available from prior research. Rightio, so we've got through all of our long boring equations and you've got a wheelward master cylinder. Now this little lovely piece here is, this is a sneak unveiling. This is a new product that I've been working on for a little bit. Like I said, we've been putting these in cars for years. We just haven't marketed as a product, but they will be for sale on the MotorFab website very soon. So yeah, just keep your eyes peeled for those. I'll get them up as quick as possible. So this is a pedal. It looks a lot like the factory pedal. For the important parts, it is the same. Obviously, your old pin with your standard bushing, everything will fit back in. Your little stopper switch, we'll take that off the other pedal and put that on for the brake light stopper. The difference being that this one is longer and a slightly different design, which gives us our pedal ratio. And also, so our kit, you can purchase it with a master cylinder with a different push rod, because the push rod needs to be longer, heim joint, bolts, and the pedal. And like I said, they'll go up. I'll let you guys all know when they're up on the website. The whole kit, like everything that we try to do, bolts straight into the car, which I'm going to bolt in for you now. And it's up under the dash, so it's a bit hard to film, and I hate working up under dashes. There's usually a bit of swearing and cursing going on. They're a bit tricky to get in there, but they're not too bad. So there it is. That fixes our pedal ratio. It gives us a much better pedal ratio. Combined with the 7/8 mass cylinder, we've done the maths. We're putting it with the HZ calipers and the Commodore calipers on the back, and this brake system, I've used it many times before, it's brilliant. This thing will stop on a dime, it really will. Bearing in mind, we did some comparisons to a VT Commodore. Bearing in mind, the VT Commodore is much heavier than the old Monaro. So there's a little sneak peek at our next product that's going to be launched. So keep your eyes peeled for those. Let's get this bad boy in the car. Check that out. I've got a rubber band on there, I haven't put the bolts back in, but there is our Wheelward master cylinder. So much more room, so much more compact. It's just a much better arrangement, much better without the booster. So we just got to run our lines now, just set that in there. We never run the old factory throttle linkage, but I just wanted to see, because this car still had it in there, I wanted to see if it fits, and it just fits. So you can run it with the factory throttle linkage if you want. That back bolt there's a little bit tricky to get to, but it's doable. But normally we run a cable throttle, so we don't have that worry. We'll run around to the inside now. Hopefully you can see under here. It's got a million tools to get the thing out. You don't have to run a big sticker in your face. Obviously, we'll just put that on there for branding. Now that is actually the same dimensions as the factory pedal, so the factory rubber pedal boot will fit on that. So for all purposes, you wouldn't see the difference. It sits a little lower and a little further out, but other than that, it fits in right where it should. Everything's the same. We've got our, it's gonna be hard to see, that's the factory stop light switch, the little bracket to push the switch off, that fits back in exactly the same spot. The hole, this is a different arrangement at the top than the standard. It's really hard to film it there, but so you can see, so that's our bolt, our heim joint's on the other side. I'm just dubbing up the lengths there at the moment, so I haven't got the jam nut on there. For you astute viewers that say you haven't got a jam nut on there, but yes, it does come with a jam nut. So you can adjust it. This hole here, this is a very different spot to the factory. That's part of how we get, part of it is a longer pedal that we make, and then part of it is also the geometry of that point. Also, we have to talk about shirts and hoodies and stuff. That you see me, this one's pretty bad. You see me wearing some pretty manky shirts because we sell out all the shirts really fast that we get done, and then I don't leave too many. This one's actually it's an old HK. I won't talk me back to the camera. That's an old HKTG one. I think I don't know if it was that year or the year before. I actually won the HKTG drag day in Bumpin in a ute, and so as a result, I ended up putting my ute on the shirt, and that's how I got to know Chris Webb, who does all the artwork for our shirts and stuff like that, and yeah, how that image of the ute came about. He did that, which I was really chuffed with. Everyone's been hitting me up, can we buy some shirts, and I'm really slack. I'm wearing old ones that, because I've run out and I sold out all the Motofab stock, and Aussie Rival stuff is all gone as well. The new Aussie Rival stuff was going to come out, but the COVID stopped that, so Aussie Rivals has been postponed, so we haven't got the shirts done yet. For those of you who have bought them in the past, you'll know when we do shirts, they sell, boom. Aussie Rivals event, there was a lineup, massive lineup of people just chomping at the bit to get their shirt, and all the merchandise we took a lot of merchandise, sold out within 10 minutes, it was gone. So I finally got around to getting with Chris Webb and getting him from Chopped Art and getting him to do a new design. So I've actually got a Monaro shirt coming out very soon. So I'm gonna show you some pictures of that right now. And there you go, I'm really excited about these shirts and hoodies, they're rad. I really like them, they're really cool. So yeah, they're not ready yet. And also I will take pre-sales, but I haven't got around to doing the website yet. So I've got to upload those to the website, which I'll let you know when it's done. And you can start ordering them because that order is underway. So really looking forward to that. So, but my advice is to get in really quick because I seem to always underdo the quantities and they sell out really fast. And I'm a bit slack in getting to a reorder to get more shirts made. So get in quick. When I let you know that they're on the website ready to go, jump on and get one straight away. Otherwise you miss out. And if you've come to events where we've sold merchandise before, it's like crazy sale and everyone just smashes into it and buys stuff really quick, which is appreciate. I'm just really slacking getting more made, but I'm getting more made. These new shirts are awesome. And when I let you know they're ready to go, jump on and order really fast. Righto, tech tip time. You guys have enjoyed the tech stuff, so I thought today rather than show, I tried to do a video of this is my ute over here in the dark. Sorry about the lighting. You will see the bits that we're talking about. Rather than show you software all the time, I'll show you the hardware the software's controlling, which is good too. So this is my fuel cell in the front. This is 20 liters. Reason why it's a front, it's a belt driven pump. These pumps don't like to suck. They like to have the fuel gravity fed to them. So a big fuel line into the pump there. It's an Enderly 110. I had to make all the bracketry and stuff to hold it. There is kits, but they didn't mount them where I wanted to mount them. Runs off a snout on the crank. That's the only belt around the belt for the fuel pump. And there's a cam belt back in there, but an alternator runs off the diff, which is sort of a good idea and a bad idea. We run an Aeromotive reg there, brilliant. We've got a filter at the back there, and I ran a wide piece, two fuel lines up to our fuel rails, from our fuel rails, bit hard to see, but there, billet atomizer, 700 pounds, I think they work about 7,000 cc's each, so they're a big injector, they're a beautiful injector, they're really good to tune with, I really like them, faultless, I've tried a few different injectors over the time, and they're just the best, they're so good. And then we run two injectors into the intake. They're Bosch 044s with a fan spray to cool the charge down. And then, yeah, we also run a pump up inside the garter, just on a button to prime the engine. So, yeah, that just helps with the belt-driven pump. It's at idle, or at uncranking, you're not spinning it fast enough to build fuel pressure. So methanol cars, quite often you've got to spray them. Whereas I just run a, I've just got a button here, and that just primes fuel to the engine. Should be able to start it actually. It hasn't been started for a while, but switch it on. Get some juice up to it. There you go, the prime pump makes a world of difference to starting these things. Cold winter's day with no prime pump, you're not going to start it that easy. Really, always starts easy. So yeah, there you go, so that's the fuel system, and what I'll do is I'll break down. Then from that, now you know what the hardware, what the software's controlling, so I can show you our fuel pressure and our fuel curves and all that sort of thing. And what we're controlling when we're making changes in the software, what it's controlling at this end. So obviously when we're changing our duty cycle on our injectors, we are dealing with these wires here and the opening and closing of the injector. So there you go, she's still stone cold. And I've also got separate maps for these intake injectors, which I can show you through. And show you where, why, and where I bring those in, and trying to keep the charge cool. And you got a whole heap of boost reference lines at the back here, which I'll show you through on the tune. You got a whole heap of MAC valves, all sorts of things to make it happen. So there's a lot to play with in the software, and all of this stuff is the hardware that software controls. So I'll keep this one pretty short, but over the weeks and months to follow, we'll get more into detail about this stuff and how I tune it and what I do. Here's Chevy come to say hello. Hey, buddy. It's dinner time, isn't it, mate? So, yeah, I hope you've enjoyed that little snapshot. And we'll look over turbo and boost and all that sort of stuff in the episodes to come. Follow white rabbit.